So this is the free motion quilting tutorial for lightning bolt. This works exactly like McTavishing in the sense that we're going to create four parallel lines of stitching meeting at a central point and then branching off with new motifs from that. So you start with, of course, your two lines of stitching, travel, and then come up with your third line of stitching, hit that point, and echo back down for a fourth line of stitching. In this sense, I wanted to get back over to that other side, so I traveled some and ran up with a fifth line of stitching so I could get to this area. And this is very similar to McTavishing, only instead of using swirly lines, like cartoon hair in the sense for McTavishing, we're going to be using very sharp angles and very pointy points in order to create these lightning bolts. Right here, I really wanted to show you how you kind of fill in the weird areas. When you're quilting an actual quilt, not a 4-inch square like I'm doing right here, you're always going to end up with kind of those odd areas where your motifs have filled up most of the space, but there's that little bit of space where you don't have quite enough room to quilt a whole motif. What you want to do is you kind of want to chop it up into pieces. And as you can see here, I'm kind of quilting a nice long tip and then kind of the middle, you know, maybe the body of the fill. And then sometimes I just quilt some parallel straight lines. The biggest thing is just to continue to change your direction. Don't stitch just 15 parallel lines all on top of each other, because that's pretty noticeable. Just, you know, stitch about 5 lines and then change your direction. 5 more lines, change your direction, and it will continue to look just as variegated, and your eye won't catch it like it would otherwise. So here's what it looks like when you finish. And for more free motion quilting videos, please check out my website, daystyledesigns.com.